and welcome to my channel. Today I've got a body paint look for you, and I thought I'd just start off this time with just my bandeau top and a mostly bare face. I did already work today, so I do have concealer and powder underneath my eyes, but nothing else. And yeah, just basically do this journey together, because I don't know either what I'm going to do. I mean, you maybe already, I don't know how I'm going to do the thumbnail, but you might have already seen the end result in the thumbnail. I'm hoping it's good, because I don't know yet either. I really don't have anything in specific planned for this particular look. Other than I want it to be holiday themed, but that's it. So yeah, let's get started. Okay, I thought I grabbed a towel, but it happens to be still behind my background screen. Be right back. Okay, I'm first pinning my hair back, because I started and then I realized I would get my hair caught up in it. Anyway, I'm just using my regular makeup brushes. So far I haven't noticed any problems with using those for this kind of stuff. But yeah, I'm just using those because they're comfortable and they're around. And it's just a matter, in my opinion, the most difficult thing about body paint is figuring out how much water to use. I really can't help you with that. It's just a matter of getting to know your own body paint. I use Crayola, and anything I've used will be below in the video description, by the way. Of course, you don't need to use the exact same brands as I do. But I use Crayola, but maybe Meron is different, I don't know, like other brands. So yeah, it's just something you're gonna have to figure out for yourself. Okay, yeah, this is as even as I could get it. Like, if you really want, like, this is two layers of paint, by the way. If you really want to, like, get really good, amazingly professional advice, I do advise you to watch Make Your Look on YouTube, because basically all I know about face paint I learned from watching her videos. But anyway, yeah, this is what we're left with now. By the way, I used to do an internship at a farm, and we used to paint boats there. Like, they had boats for, like, rowing and stuff like that. Anyway, and we had to paint them in the exact same shade of blue. That really reminded me of it. I actually got those more streak-free than my own body, even though metal is really hard to paint. Like, it doesn't suck up the paint. Anyway, you don't care about that probably. Metal is hard to paint. This was the same color as with boats. Not important. I'm going to add snow now with white face paint. Body paint. Yeah. Okay, I'm just doing the white all around. And as you can probably tell, probably not actually, just believe me, my bandeau top is by this point sort of painted. So far the paint has always come out again. You know, it is water dissolvent and all. But still, just to be sure, I do advise you to use a bandeau top that you're not overly attached to. Like, don't use your favorite expensive name brand bandeau top or anything. Just use, you know, underwear that you don't really care about what it looks like, because otherwise it might just not be fun if you end up ruining it on accident. Okay, I can't say clothing painted on, but I can say that I painted on my clothing at this point. Okay, I just decided that there's going to be a snowman. Okay, I actually have a towel on my lap now. You don't want to know how often I've already missed the towel and instead, out of habit, wipe my brush on my chair. Oops. And we're also just going to add some falling snow. Rather huge snowflakes. Then I'm just going to grab some more colors on a eyeliner brush, and I'm going to give my snowman a little bit more detail. Also, I have silver glitter on my face, and no, I have no idea how that happened. I didn't touch glitter yet, so let's just ignore that. You You know, by the way, what I never quite understood about the whole thing of a snowman with a broom? Who goes to swipe their path with a broom in winter? Like, I could understand a shovel. But maybe they use brooms for it just because, you know, because they weren't used in winter. Okay, I gotta admit that this snowman actually looks better than any snowman I've ever built in real life. Like, I live in the Netherlands, we don't get a lot of snow here. So I don't really get a lot of practice at all, whatsoever. Tragic, isn't it? Anyway, point being, yeah, like mine usually look like weird heaps of snow with rocks in them. But anyway, I'm also going to paint a little tree, I think. Yeah. I'm gonna grab a bigger brush for this, because otherwise I'll still be working like I started out with the eyeliner brush, but then I realized it would take me like 12 years to finish. And I'm starting off with a pale green, because I already started using it, and then I remembered I actually do have a darker green. So I'm just gonna use this as my base layer and then put the other green over top of it. By the way, one other thing with body paint, to me at least, like this side of my body is a lot harder to paint than the other side. Simply because this is my dominant side, like this is my dominant hand. And like on a model you can obviously walk around said model. And I am quite stretchy, but so far I haven't managed to be able to walk around myself. So you're stuck either, you know, painting this side of your body with your non-dominant hand, which I find very difficult on myself. I can do it on other people, just on myself is very difficult. Or you can instead, you know, bend your arm really awkwardly to get it done. Yeah, they say practice makes perfect, so that's something I'm still practicing in. Now I'm just detailing the edge around the whole color thing I painted with a metallic body paint by Crayola. It gives a little bit of effect, not a lot. These really are the only paints by Crayola that I don't really like, just because they don't really show up all that much. But yeah, the other stuff is really good, obviously, otherwise I wouldn't be using it. On second thought, I'm just going to take this glittery paint over the entire color. Okay, now I'm just dabbing the slightly darker shade of green over the tree. Well, just wiping it, repainting it really. And I'm going to do the same thing with the snowman, obviously not with the green paint. But I'm just going to go over the tree and the snowman again to make them a little bit more opaque. Okay, I've sat still for so long that my leg is now asleep, and in other news, if the snowman looks different than it did before, well, you're absolutely right, because I couldn't manage to paint around the details when I redid the white. I instead just repainted his details, like his face and his buttons. But anyway, now that's done, I'm going to go on to this tree again, and I'm going to make it a Christmas tree with some decorations. Just adding some random colors of balls first. By the way, on the subject of where you would actually wear this look, yeah, I don't think this look is very wearable at all, really. But this is the sort of thing that I would recommend doing when you're bored. Like, I don't know, like I work as a postman, so I'm pretty busy at work during this period in the year. But for example, if you, you know, have a job where you're not actually working a lot, like when you have a job that, you know, gives you off between like Christmas and New Year's. Some companies, at least here in the Netherlands, do that. You know, this is just the sort of thing that you could do on a rainy afternoon when you don't have anything else to do and you're bored, but you want to do something, so yeah. And also, me personally, I always love doing body paint stuff and even nail arts, just to relax, really. I suppose more conventionally, you could also just paint on paper. But I just prefer to paint on my body because, well, I gotta admit, I'm sort of personal order issues throwing stuff away. And I used to do origami, for example. But then I would feel sorry for tossing away the origami pieces. So I would end up keeping like a gazillion, you know, paper flowers and stuff like that. Which really in daily life isn't anything useful to hang on to. But I did because then I would feel sorry about tossing it. So I wouldn't, and yeah. So basically with nail art and body paint, the plus to me is that I can have my creative outlet. But it doesn't create the, you know, the stuff to keep, really. Because you can take footage of it, you know, with a camera, and that's just, you know, it's there, but it doesn't take up any actual space. But you don't need to actually actively, you know, keep it around in a place where it, like, you don't need to store it, is what I mean. And then some shininess in all the balls. Then I'm just going to add some tinsel. And really, just the crisscross lines are just going to give the whole plastic-y glitter effect that those things have. Now, I don't think a Christmas tree is complete without a tree topper, so I'm going to add a star on top. I actually always use those, like, shaped tree toppers and not stars, but it's easier to paint. Okay, this tree topper sort of looks as if it once fell down and then got put back together again. Nevertheless, we're just gonna highlight it. Now, I'm just going to add a little bit of an outline and some more detail on both the snowman and the tree using a liner brush. This is actually a nail art brush. This one is quite long, which I like for this kind of thing. You know, but of course you can just use an eyeliner brush if you don't have a nail art brush. But yeah, and I'm adding as little water as possible to the black paint. Just enough that it becomes, you know, usable. But not too much, because I don't want to risk it becoming too opaque. Because I want it to be more of a dark gray, really, than to really have it be stark black. Another plus of doing this not on full opacity is also that if you do make a mistake, it won't show up all that much. Now, before I forget, I'm just going back in the white body paint as well. To highlight the black top hat, because, you know, outlining an already black object isn't really going to do much. Okay, highlighter done, so we're going to go back to the shadows and outlines now. Okay, let's be real here. Nail art, like the kind of nail art that I like doing with like very, very teeny tiny details on the nail. Well, that's still easier than this. Okay, now I twisted my wrist in like 5 different directions that it was not supposed to be twisted in. Finally onto the tree. Okay, and now we're left with the final results. So yeah, this is what it became, and by the way, in the armpits, it actually stays quite nicely. Which is surprising because I really thought it was going to be disastrous, but yeah, I'm impressed. Not that it's something that I need in daily life, but still. Anyway, yeah, point being, I really hope you enjoyed watching this video, and that it might have been useful in case you want to, for some reason, paint a winter landscape on yourself as well. Or at any rate, I hope it was just enjoyable to watch me try to figure out how to accomplish this, because this entire thing was really just trial and error and just trying to get it to work. Yeah, anyway, I'll definitely keep practicing at painting on myself. It's so much easier on someone else, seriously. But anyway, if you did enjoy it, for whatever reason, please click the like button, it would really help me out. And if you want to see more videos, you can always subscribe to my channel. I actually mostly do, you know, wearable eye looks and stuff like that. For now, at any rate, thank you very much for watching this video. I hope you have a wonderful day, and I hope to see you next time. Bye!